You're in the criminal museum.
I wonder if this was originally a
dungeon? It's certainly possible. This is all in... Oh, here we go. Procedures for evidence. All right. Let's get some pictures here.
That's cool that's in English.
Dude, these people are brutal.
I haven't even gone over there to look at that yet.
Ouch.
This is super cool, guys. All the stages.
Oh, yeah.
Let's take a look here, right? So you've got, this is the, yeah. So they would strap you to this.
And then put your legs in there.
It would tie your legs up. Or tie your arms up there, and they would pull your legs out and stop it there. Here, kind of the same concept. But,
ooh,
that would break your neck. They would put your head right there, and they would tighten the rope until your neck snaps. Man, that's brutal.
A thumb screw?
Yeah, thumb screws. Thumb screws!
Stretch. Raise the accused.
So is this. This and that was to stretch. They'd like,
oh.
So check this guy. Check this out. The spiky seating, which technically, if you're just sitting on it, would probably hold your weight up. They would weigh you down.
And then you're just like, I know, but they're laying on spikes.
Yeah, so they're
look at that.
It didn't
say. Ooh.
They got a rolling pin there. I guess they can do it by hand if you want to really do it good.
Yikes.
Well, I guess you put your hands, your wrists up here in the end.
Yeah.
Your feet on the back end, and they crank it. Here they do the same thing. They snap your neck.
And here's a picture of that thing.
Put your head in there.
That thing right there is this. Something like this.
Ah.
So they hung weights from you, just suspended your body.
So your arms would pop out of socket, and your legs. Ooh, that's brutal. Law of torture. Check that out. That is a sweet book.
The call of
Do you remember
torture?
That the woman taught us?
Is this a,
15 bombs in his location.
Well, it's all in German, so I don't know what it says, but, oh, that's the notes transcribed, I guess.
The witch trial.
Yeah, and he had like a stone on his
feet. Protocol of Catherine Ronsenbach's confession of witch trial. That is so neat. It feels really good down here.
That's true.
Like. Is that glare all in the way? Yeah.
Yeah, this stuff is
protocol of witness. The theory of torture.
It wasn't done away with until the 18th
century. People, I mean, whether they confess or didn't confess, they were going to be tortured.
Water torture, commonly practiced in France and Spain, where water, usually holy water, was poured down the throat of the person bound to the bench. Waterboarding, indeed. Hey, there's stuff downstairs. There's more stairs down. So I guess we'll go down before we go up. Careful. Ooh, don't hit your head. All right. See where you're like bound up, chained to the rope. Oh, it goes up that way.
It's lost.
What is it?
It's a 12 sensory fan.
Man, it feels so good down here.
Better, right?
I can't. Yeah.
1734.
That's a breaking neck, I'm guessing. Choking.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so let's check this out, everybody. There's the chair right there. They'd strap you in and essentially choke you out. Yeah.
Break your spine.
No, it's
brutal. And that right there was for your arms and legs. Like hog-tied mode. I do like all these impressions.
And they, whenever you have like an envelope, you would put like wax on it and then you like press it on there. So it's not like a torture thing.
Unless they do put it on a person.
Yeah. And the other one is more like you can make put like a...
I don't know if that's necessarily a torture device, but it's cool.
Like they pour money in there and they press it into like...
It's a coin.
But it's
coin press
water,
and some other, other such
fun. You can do that in like boxes, and you can like body has to be
a what?
This plaque, or not this is a
oh wow, it shows a picture of how it works. That's pretty.
That's for your feet, boy.
Pretty heinous right there. Little strap. Ooh, they could twist down the nail things and smash your hands, I guess, is what that's for? Yeah. Smashy, smashy. That's terrible. See these things here? Right here? They would tighten it up so it's all nice and closed. They would insert it into certain orifices and they would rotate it back open until you essentially bled out, which is brutal. And not at all cool. Wow. Gross. Gross.
With modern medicine such as it was, I'm thinking once you got put in something like that,
there was no.
You needed a cup.
No, you probably got some kind of infection.
I'm just saying, if your finger got smashed, right?
Yeah, yeah.
This book is from 1756.
Principle. Dronung?
To prevent misuse by officials.
Ooh. Okay, I can see that.
And keep it double over.
Certainly an unpleasant experience. Oh well. Yeah, we came from that way. Yeah, we're. Hey, there's actually like. There's actually like text on this wall.
Is this like 1576 maybe?
HVM.
Probably.
Cool. I like it. Grain scale?
Are they collecting excrement from the animals?
This is like a bunch of old documentation too.
Where's that at? Here.
It's in England.
Why?
The yellow one.
Guild law. It's wax seals. This is like totally be like awesome pirate documents. It's not, of course. But this letter shows that the apprentice student is in the first stages of learning and becoming a master craftsman. The letter's for a cook. Seals, birth certificate, Butcher's Guild order. This has turned out to be an awesome, awesome museum. I'm really digging this documentation. What is that? Issued by Prince Sovereign Clemens, Wenceslas of Poland. In Latin, and Bishop of Trier in Augsburg, resident city of Dillingen. Please note the very nice graphic document. Yes, please do. Please, office policy. Reaching. What? Policy. Office policy. This policy is for good office procedures, is for respect of God, cleanliness, and punctuality. Personnel will be present only on weekdays from 6 to 6. Sunday will be used for going to church every morning. In the main office, you will say a prayer. If there's a good reason, everyone is expected to work overtime. Okay. 1966 is this document. So it's actually not that old, but it's still cool. Anyway, the bondos are fun, but not really. seems relevant to what we're doing here. This thing is the stuff of nightmares. So, as you can see, it's closed right now. But when it's open, there were nails or spikes that are in it. Very long spikes. And they put you inside the Iron Maiden and slam the door shut. At which point, you would bleed to death from all the puncture wounds that you've received. Usually, it takes a while, though. Iron Maiden's super brutal. Here's an example of the spikes in terms of their length. And potency. Origins of the Iron Maiden. Ooh. I can scroll in on that and we'll go down. Pause it as you need to. I might read it later, but I'm just trying to get through it now. Historical evidence has been found of an Iron Maiden ever being used as an instrument of torture or execution. It was just used as a restraint. Interesting. Well, that's not as exciting. But fair enough. It's a sword of enormous. The sword is huge. This is the kind of sword that would have been used for executions. Because of its weight. It actually wasn't usually very sharp because it weighed so much. They would just let it drop and it would cut heads off. Which is violent. Ultra violent. Little Iron Maidens. More Iron Maiden stuff. Read it to your heart's content. I will, of course, probably be reading this. This is a document. This is imagery of documentation. Oh, there we go.
Awesome.
Okay. Oh, that's fun. A catch. So you can't. The witch catcher. Drunk tank? Oh, nice, okay. That's what that is. That's the drunk tank. Nope. Sorry. Lots of chaining devices. These are what now? Some kind of wax seals, maybe? Funfuls and woodsy folk. More wax seal stuff. Heavy stones wrapped in. That's heavy wood wrapped in metal, so they couldn't flee, I guess. Or, yeah.
It's like things like that. How to carry it. His own shame.
Have you seen the big old swords yet? Not that one, although that is cool. It's around the other side. These coins? It's like different coins from different areas. Iron court marker. Okay, here we go. Chastity belts. Heart for one side and that for the other. That's interesting, to be sure. Oh man, that's some crazy stuff went down back then. Chastity belts. A hat? Shawl? The shawl wreath. Straw wreath, sorry. For dishonorable and immoral girls having such a wreath on their heads, they were guided through the so-called black bridal gate when they went to church for their wedding. In many cases, the wedding ceremony did not take place in church at all, but in some inn. Oh, okay. That was for out of wedlock type stuff. Yes. What is this? Frauenhaben, women's bonnets. So funny hats.
You know, one of you told Slutty Jones you had to wear this, right? These are really it's metal.
All these shame masks for men. 18th century with nose part and perforate lower jaw plate. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I got a little bit of red about that stuff right there. When the men were gone, the locksmith had a key for
it. Sounds funny.
Yeah, these are shame masks. Wouldn't want to wear one of those. It looks very uncomfortable. Although they're very well done, I must say, much by way of pig motif and birds and just crazy masks. That one's almost jester-like. Donkey ears. Wow. This is a really cool museum. I like it very much. Some of it's like super brutal. I didn't realize that the Iron Maiden was never used for torture purposes. At least no documented.
It might be different in Spain.
That's fair. It's certainly possible.
That's when they put a fire on.
Well, that sucks. That would suck. 1361. They put a red box around it? How rude is that? No, it's cool. Ecclesiastical rites. This looks like Elvish. It's not, clearly, but looks like Elvish. It's a lot of wax seals. Oh, okay, that's fair. This is a document on beer tax. issued by 44 cities of the Mark Brandenburg, dated 1513, 44 city seals in wax hanging on 10 braids, silk ropes. That is awesome. Okay. So this is the beer tax document. With 44 seals from different city-states. Well, that's fair. Or squingy finger smashiness. Documentation, just for sealed documents. Pouch for the official seal. Nice. Okay. Wax, colored wax, sealed with wax and roughed. And then, okay. I can see that. That's super cool.
Wow. It's a big wax seal.
Obviously, there's not really enough time to look at everything, but this is really awesome, awesome place. Oh, is this like a showcase of the different? No, it's like a medieval town layout.
Well, yeah, but it's got people going.
Oh, hey, there's a dungeon down here. Check it out. There's a rack. And there's some folks being all.
This is not interesting. This is. Yeah.
You see the guy on the rack? Down there?
I'm not connecting my issue with.
It's a bit modern.
Okay, so chained up. Here's the drunk tank. There's a guy in the sewage, which is really bad. Not good. It's hanging up there. Is there maiden in this? Can you find all the methods of torture? Where's Waldo? Not really. Excellent. Donkey for disgracefulness. Some of these donkey things were actually built big enough and like it was kind of pointy and it would weigh you down until you split in half. Maybe not the donkey specifically, but I've heard that before.
You're distracted to it until you. You couldn't keep yourself up off of them long. Few hours in bed.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be highly uncomfortable after about 2 or 3 days.
What's that?
Sitting on that homemade doggy thing with the pitch.
Yeah, that'd be most unpleasant. Oh, there's some ceiling stuff here, but we're not all really. Right.
There's an upstairs.
There's
an upstairs?
There's more stairs up, yeah.
There's
more stairs up.
Where's Alan?
All right, let's go. We'll be real quick.
What time is it?
3:47.
All right.
Where's she go? This is all new. Yep, new stuff. Not a lot. I like all these old documents, though, for sure. War Masks of Shame. That's a troll.
If they don't have a suit and a friend, it's going to be very
long. Is that a troll? That's cool. I'm not sure if they have a button. Oh, nice. Is this the, it's the Holy Grail.
It doesn't work.
It's the Holy Hand Grenade of Antioch, as seen on Monty Python. Check it out. Really, it's the orb. It's an orb and a scepter and what looks like the Spear of Destiny, but could be something else entirely. This is my jam right here. Look at this.
I'm not sure.
Look at all the medieval weaponry. With the glare. Come on, glare. Get out of here. These are called bardiches. It's an axe with a spear tip. And it is. It has a very long.
Husbands who mistreated their wives.
Long spear at the end there. And the axe head. Right, let's look at it from this angle. This would be better, right? So you have the spear part, axe. And of course, it was a spear, essentially, that had. A lot of crazy stuff. This is a hot box where they would seal you up in the box, little tiny box. That's an intricate lock, though. I'll tell you that. Look at how crazy that is.
When a couple fought, a heavyweight club is put in front of their door and was
horn.
Not removed until they came to an agreement.
It's a compass, a watch. Document of a notary. That's what I would love to see a museum of, like, medieval weaponry. I mean, there's a lot in here, of course, but these are bardiches and other long pole axes. I never made a character that used one, though. I was always more of an axe or sword guy. I think that's about it. We see what we can see. Take a quick jaunt over here. Oh, cool. It's a scales with different weights. The exit's over here. Yeah. Four dioramas. Always cool.
I'm too short to see that.
Is that an abacus? That is an enormous abacus? Huh. If you were a bad kid, you could get the mask. The Hannibal mask. I guess.
I also beat you.
Well, that's...
Or you had to kneel on a piece of wood.
Well, there's that too. Just a switch. This looks like... See here, Ashley? This is a very large version of the Elder Wand. This looks like the Elder Wand from Harry Potter. It's got the little bits. It's not, obviously. I don't know what it is, but it's cool. Ooh, swords. Let's take a look at the swords real quick. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. That's amazing craftsmanship. I want a sword like this. I wish I could get a sword while I'm in England, but I doubt it. Because I wouldn't be able to take it over through customs. They would get kind of angsty about that. Maybe I could mail it, but it's not going to happen. See the handle mask if you're bad? I don't know what it's for, but it's very interesting. That's just an office space. Whoa, check out their stair design. That's so crazy.
This
handrail though.
It doesn't feel right, does it?
No, it does not. I am not.
Andrew's just going down. At least it's a continuous museum, so I do like that part. Death penalty? Shiny bum. More swords. Wait, have you been in here? No. Nope, this is different. This is new. Great sword.
For each half ounce missing, the baker's weight.
Now, this sword, it's very important to note, this sword is designed this way because when they stab you with it, it makes a big open hole and you bleed out faster. That's why it's curvy. Makes for more interesting damages. It also makes for a lovely, lovely, that's a large spiky staff. The iron cage. Hey Dad, remember those from Robin Hood Men in Tights? The tongue stretchers and stuff? Hand axes and halberds. Seven limbs, such as the head.
We used skeleton keys when we lived in Germany.
I like skeleton keys. Is that a lock? That's a cool lock.
Oh, the condemned person. If I wanted to kill him old fashioned style, I didn't want to believe it. Did you read that?
No.
They'd heat them up red hot and throw them in the fire. Get the ends of them cherry red hot. And then get on the part of your body somewhere and they'd pinch your shit out of there.
Ow. That's not cool.
So you wouldn't die. That's terrible.
Here's some handout. Oh, yes. Look at this. That's a falchion. Nice. They have a falchion here.
A fragment of the Rothenburg
and a bunch of swords that look really, really good. Executioner's sword. See, it wasn't pointy, as you can see, because, oh, I'm going to zoom out. It wasn't pointy because they didn't need it pointy because they're not stabbing people with it. They're just lopping off heads. Now that is, of course, rather brutal. Hand axe, it was a full helmet kind of deal. More executioner swords. Prototype examples of gallows. Iron gallows. Some pretty cool ironwork there. Ooh, the guillotine. What fun that is, my friends. What fun that is. This is the executioner's cloak, which is very... I would be scared. I would be scared seeing a dude wearing that. So that's fair. Cutting off ears. Okay. Okay, so let's get a little scan into this. Cutting off ears. Knife used to cut off the ear or oath finger. Okay. Okay. Another beheading sword. We don't have to read the text on that. One crown. Yo. Yes, I am coming. All right. Well, that just about does it. We have finished with the museum. We're back outside. Whew. Saw a lot of cool stuff. I love looking at swords and axes and stuff, so it's a win for me. Thank you, Dad, for that. And we are going to look at the Christmas store, which I don't think I'll film any of that. But then we're going to go on the wall. I will record some of that. And we'll be back here in a little bit. Later!